How fast? Hi everyone and welcome to Tactical Combat System channel. In this video, I will talk about efficient training. What we must do, what techniques, what drills, what kind of mentality, what kind of tactics we must apply in our training in such a way that when we are in a real life or death situation, the training will be efficient and we'll be able to survive or to increase our chances of surviving in that moment. So in order to learn anything, whether it's math, for example, or playing guitar, or I don't know, throwing a basketball, or deploying your weapon, you need to create and to strengthen the pathways in your brain. These are called neural pathways. So basically, when you are doing an activity without thinking, it's muscle memory. Muscle memory lives in the brain, not in the muscles. So your brain controls all your muscle movements by activating these neural pathways for each kind of movement. When you learn a new activity, by repetition and repetition, these neural pathways are becoming more strong. So in time, you can master that movement, that new skill. When we talk about combat, one of the most important thing is that you need fast to learn that skill, because in 1 month, in 3 months, in 6 months, you can be in a life or death situation, so you need that skill to survive. So for this thing, to learn faster your techniques, your skill, I will give you some key elements. Number one is to get the fundamentals right. If you are missing some of the fundamentals, you are creating bad habits, and this is blocking, this is stopping you for learning faster, and also can cost your life, because we are talking about combat, if you will be in a life or death situation. When I'm talking about getting the fundamentals right, I'm referring that at the beginning, when you start, for example, learning the skills with the knife, you must put accent on that basic techniques. Until you didn't master that techniques, don't pass to the next level. Don't jump to advanced techniques if you don't have a good, solid base. The second one is take it easy at the beginning. Break down your techniques in chunks of learning. Yeah? Break it down in small tasks. Yeah? Don't try to make from the beginning all the technique, because it will be harder for the brain to learn that new skill. But if you break it down in segments, it will be more easy. And I give you an example. If you want to learn tomorrow to, making jugglers with some balls, with 6 balls, yeah, like at the circus, and you want to start from the beginning with 6 balls, it will be impossible. It will be impossible to learn it, yeah, and especially to learn it fast. And it will take a very, very long time to master, yeah? But if you start, if you segmentate that in starting with two balls, then put it another ball, then another ball, it will be more easy. The same idea is coming here when we are talking about combat techniques. For example, if I want to exercise a drill with my handgun, this being deploying of the weapon and also moving and I aligning my sights, if the technique is catching the clothing with the hand, in this moment moving to not remain in a fixed position, a fixed target is a dead target, I repeat, and also catching my handgun, making the good grip, deploying my handgun, meeting with the other hand, align the sights and be ready to shoot, then after finishing checking the barrel to see to not have a malfunction, maybe I need again to use my handgun. If I want to learn, I am at the beginning and I want to learn this from the start like this, it will be more hard, it will be more difficult. Yeah, this is the reason why this technique you must split it in more parts. For example, number one is taking the shirt, liberate the clothes and catch the gun. So this is only one. You can start from all kind of position, one. So for the beginning, only this is my movement. Not complicated, not exaggerating moves. I am trying to remain and to use as less movements that I can to do that movement very fast, that technique very fast. Yeah. The gun that I'm using, it's a training gun, so I'm using it only here for showing you the techniques that I am doing. This is the first. And after this, I have catching, grabbing, taking out, barrel already orientated towards the target. Yeah. Then moving the gun and coming with the other hand, meeting together, take the correct grip and align my sights. And of course, after we put the other segment in this drill, that is the movement. So one hand is going on the closest, it's liberating the gun. One is going on the gun. In this moment, I am moving, I am aligning the sights, and I am ready to use it. Of course, the movement, it's more than this. Yeah, I was making only one big step. But when you are in this kind of situation, it's moving. Yeah, I'm not having space here. I'm exiting also from the camera. So you understand the idea. I only want to tell you that when you want to learn the technique, it's better to make these small tasks. You learn the first part of the drill, the second, the third, you put it together and the brain will learn it much faster. The same if you want to learn the knife, yeah, the drill of deploying the knife, I am catching my clothes, I am liberating, I am taking the knife out and I am stabbing, for example, and moving, or moving and stabbing, yeah. So it's the same concept, the same idea, nothing is changing. I am starting and learning on the segments. First this and this. Simple. This. Taking the clothes, catching. Taking, catching. Only this movement at the beginning. Liberating the knife, catching the knife. I am mastering this kind of movement, then I am passing to the other. Liberating, catching the knife, take it out. I repeat again, out, because here I can also stab and also throw it, yeah? And then, of course, I'm putting also the movement. Again, the movement is much more than this. Much in laterally or in the other direction or in the back. But I'm exiting from the camera, you see. And you know from my previous video what are the techniques. I only wanted now to clarify how is the best way in which you can train. And I am moving. So, very important to understand all these things. Split it in segments, in small tasks, and you will learn it faster. The third most important key element is get a coach, get an instructor. Otherwise, you will only guess what you are mistaking in your techniques. Yeah. And the best thing to advance, to learn the movements, to learn that kind of activity is by a feedback, by somebody that knows that technique, that knows what you are doing, and it's correcting you. So by this way, you can correct your bad habits and learn the good basic, good fundamentals, and advance very fast on mastering your skill. The fourth one is to avoid overloaded information. The majority of the students at the beginning, they want to take as much information as they can. But this is not good. You must begin to practice and to limit yourself to the basics, and step by step coming with new kind of information that is helping you advance to the next level. The fifth key element is practice. Guys, if you are not practicing, you cannot master a skill. If you are practicing one time on the week, if you are practicing two times, even three times on the week, it's not enough. We are talking here about combat skills. We are talking about having some skills that you must apply it, being able to apply it in a dead or live situation. Yeah. So we don't talk about learning to sing to a guitar. You must apply these techniques in that situation in which the adrenaline is rushing in your body, in which you must protect your life, your family, and the others around you. So it's more complicated than learn, I don't know, to throw darts to a target. Because that technique, that skill that you are learning must be so perfect and must be so good learned in such a way that it's becoming an automatic thing, this muscle memory, without thinking, to be able to have a response in that moment. And the most important thing when I'm talking about practice is that it's better to make small sessions of training regularly than to make longer ones, but one today and the other in 3 days. So remember, small sessions regularly, to not have burnout, and also to be able to take all that information, to learn that techniques very good. The sixth important key element is why. Guys, this question, it must be there in your mind all the time. Why you want to learn this skill? I want to learn this skill because I want to be able to protect my life, my family, the ones around me. So I will face maybe tomorrow or in 1 year or I don't know when in my life, it's existing the probability that I will be in a life or death situation, and I must be ready to protect what I love, protect my life and the ones around me. So this is the motivation. The motivation is the key. This will help you in the moments in which you want to quit, in which you don't want to train, in which, I don't know, other kind of thoughts are coming in your mind. Maybe to me it will not happen, or I don't know what. This, why, this answer, this motivation will help you all the time to continue your way on this path. Another key element is using visualization in your training. I was saying also in past videos, in my previous videos, that visualization is a powerful tool that you can implement in your training. There are professional athletes that they are using this kind of techniques to learn faster their skills and to become better in what they are doing. Yeah, so visualization is very, very important. It's calling basically NPL, neuro-linguistic programming. So you program your brain not only physically, but I repeat again, the one that is giving the command to your muscle is the brain. So the visualization, it's using the brain to train and to learn a skill. So many times when you are doing your drill, if you want to operate the knife, to take my clothes, liberate the knife, catch the knife, taking out, stab, for example, This you can do also between the techniques, staying in a normal relaxed position, and visualize all this movement, how you catch with the left hand the shirt, how you come with the strong hand, how you catch the knife, how you take it out, how you are stabbing, and all this thing. And after you visualize very clearly what you are doing, then you pass to the physical repetition. Very important visualization technique. So guys, now we are passing to the part that it's separating combat skills from other kind of skills, yeah? If we are taking all the new activities or skills that you want to learn, these key factors that I was, key elements that I was saying to you until now are applying to all in general, yeah? And if we take, for example, playing to the guitar and learning combat skills, these key elements are applying to the both. Only that now I will tell you the part that it's only for the combat skills, and if it's missing from your training, the training is in vain, it will not help you with nothing. And for this we must remember ourselves the fight, flight, freeze, survival response of your body. Yeah. So in that moment in which you are in a dangerous situation, in your body are beginning to happen a lot of changes. The adrenaline is rushing in your body, the breathing is increasing, the heartbeats are increasing, your palm will sweat, the blood is redirected to big groups of muscles, you have tunnel vision, your fine motor skills will not be anymore functioning at the same level. So a lot of changes that will influence your response in that moment. This is the reason why we must understand all these things that they are happening in that moment are natural things. They are happening because this is the mechanism of protection of your body. Yeah? So all this is normal to happen in your body. The idea is that by acknowledging, by identifying all these changes that they are happening, you will be able also in the training to understand what kind of factors, what kind of stress factors you can include, you can implement in your training in such a way that you can copy or you can reproduce a little bit some of these changes. And now I'm coming again to the discussion of playing the guitar and combat skills. If you are good playing to the guitar and you are singing, playing all the day and repeating very good all the songs, it's okay, you are good. But now if we take this guy that is playing to a guitar and we put it, for example, on a chair in the middle of a highway to sing his songs that he was singing perfectly when it was in a relaxed mode, and now cars are passing near him, very close to hit him, his repetition, his way of playing, it will not be at the same level because now his body is entering in that fight, flight, freeze mode because it's in a dangerous situation. So he cannot play anymore the same as in a relaxed mode because his fine motor skills, playing at the guitar, it's using fine motor skills, the fingers, they will not operate at the same level. So it's the same when we go to the combat skills to understand. If all the time in your training, you are making your drills and you are training in a relaxed mode, in a normal comfort zone, implementing your training some stress factors, it will not help you with nothing. You will be in the same situation like the guy that is singing at the guitar, very good in his house, but then he is in a dangerous situation and the fine motor skills are not functioning at the same level. And I give you a simple example. If you have, for example, a folding knife that it's, you must open it with a finger pushing this flipper button, maybe you can do it in a relaxed mode very fast. But if you are not training under stress factors in a real situation, the probability that you don't manage to open that folding knife are very high. So you are training, you are home, you are in your gym, in your, I don't know, place where you are making your training every day, and you exercise and you repeat and repeat and repeat all the time with a folding knife, pushing here, opening the folding knife. So this is a fine motor skill. I must use my finger here to make this kind of movement. And again, when we talk about learning the basics, the fundamentals, you must learn it slow. You must learn it step by steps until you master that fundamentals. When you master the fundamentals, then the next step is this: to implement in your training stress factors in such a way that you reproduce these kind of changes that are happening in reality. And this, I repeat again, the heartbeats are increasing, respiration, it's increasing. How I can recreate, how I can reproduce this kind of change in my body? Very simple, putting physical effort, using kettlebells, running, making push-ups, pull-ups, a circuit, in such a way that I'm increasing the heartbeats, the respiration, and then the breathing, and then I'm going in front of the target and I'm making my drills. Yeah, then I will go and try to operate my weapon and make my drill. Then how I can reproduce the idea of losing my fine motor skills? Very simple. I go with the hands in a ice bucket. Put the hands there 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 10 minutes, I don't know, until your fingers are not you are not able to move the fingers at the same level like before. Then try to deploy your folding knife from your pocket, open it, and make your technique. So by reproducing this kind of change in your body, you will train your brain to adapt himself in that moment and to be able to open or to use his weapon also in that moment. So by doing these kind of exercises, you will reproduce these kind of changes that will happen in that moment, and the brain will be able much faster to adapt to that change. Another very important aspect is the majority of the criminal attacks are happening in low light environment. So if you're never trained in low light environment, you will not be able to have a good response, and your chances of surviving in that moment are very low because you didn't do that. You didn't train, you didn't program your brain to adapt to that kind of situation. When you will understand these changes that are happening in your body, then you will be able to modify your training and to come with new ideas. After I was understanding all these things, for example, this with the fine motor skills, and I was all the time carrying a folding knife. This folding knife, that for using this folding knife, you must push the flipper and make this movement, yeah? By understanding that my fine motor skills will not operate at the same level, I come with this idea that I was showing you in previous videos. A paracord, you put it at the belt, very simple, you make a loop, like this, then the knife, you take it and you put a paracord, a strong paracord, between the blade and the handle of the knife. It will not cut so easy. Then I take my knife, put it in my pocket. When I need to operate it, I must not be afraid that this fine motor skill pushing here with the finger, it will not work in that moment. I must only take it out, catching by the handle, make a strong movement, and it's already opened. Because this is doing this paracord. When I'm making this movement, you understand the idea. When I'm making this movement, catching by the knife, the paracord will open the blade. So I don't need anymore this fine motor skill. I have a strong grip, a gross motor skill, and only I make this movement and it's ready to use. So it's very important thing. So making this, I will increase my chances that I can open my folding knife in that moment. Based on the same concept of understanding your body and what is happening in that moment, I was also coming with idea for the tourniquet. This is a soft tourniquet. And the soft tourniquet is coming with these rubber bands that I put on it because you can folding it more better than if it's not having this, yeah? So if I was having only the fold, the tourniquet, and I was putting, let's say, in my pocket, and it's happening something that I must apply the tourniquet very fast to take it out and to make this with the fingers to this rubber band and take it out is not so easy. So maybe it's seeming now because we are in a relaxed mode. But if you are in a real situation, this, it will be a hard task. So I was coming with a simple idea, this loop that you can take for telephones or for other devices. I catch it, I make a loop on the rubber band, and this, very simple, it's coming on my belt. Just a moment. It's coming on my belt. And now I put it in my pocket. So when I need to take it, I only catch it and make this. And I can apply the tourniquet. Yeah. So only by understanding these elements, you will be able to find better solutions to increase your chances of surviving or to save somebody else when we talk about tourniquets or tactical medicine. What other elements can make of our training an efficient one? And I am keeping the same discussion in my last videos and also now about two main factors, simplicity and efficiency. This is all the time must be part of your mentality when you are training. Simple and efficient. And again, I repeat that in a real situation, in that life or death situation, when you are in a fight, flight, freeze response, complex thinking will not be at the same level. Yeah. So you'll not be able to make complex activity in the same way as before. So guys, it's very important to understand that for the training to be efficient, for the things that you do in your training to be efficient, is following the two things, simplicity and efficiency. And for making that, I am all the time trying to combine movements. For example, if I use one movement for deploying the knife, to use the same movement or the same pattern of movements for deploying the gun. The same if I am using hand-to-hand combat, I am trying to have like the same pattern for using the knife. Because in this way, I am not coming with more complex or more moves that my brain must learn. So I have the same thing. So if I am talking about my knife, I have my fixed blade on the level of the belt and my gun in the appendix position with the holster. Yeah. So if I am here and I want to deploy my knife from this position, I have the hand is catching the claws. I am liberating the knife. I am coming with the other hand on the knife. If I want to make the same thing for the gun, to deploy my gun, it's the same pattern of movement. My hand is catching the shirt and I'm coming with the hand. So nothing was changing until here. It's the same movement. If I decide to put a knife at my back and here the gun, it's totally something different. So the brain must learn another movement in plus. So this, it will be more harder in a real situation to make transitions or other stuff like this. But in this modality, I have the same movement for the both. If I want to deploy it with one hand, it's the same. This is, I cannot use it or I must grab somebody or protect. I'm using only one hand. It's catching the t-shirt. I'm liberating the knife and I'm with the hand on the knife. If I want to make to the gun, it's the same. I can do it with all the hand or only with the thumb finger, yeah? But the movement is the same. If I'm passing to the next thing, I have one, two up to hit. with the gun, one, two up, meeting together to align the sights and shoot. So it's basically the same concept. We don't change nothing. There are some people that, for example, they don't want to carry one bullet on the chamber. They don't want, yeah? I advise them, and my advice for all the people that they are carrying weapons, it's to train enough in such a way that they have that confidence and they can carry their weapon with one on the chamber, because that time that you need to, you are already having a reaction, so you are slower than the action. So also you must have this time to put the bullet on the chamber. It's other dead time that you cannot use the gun because you don't, it's not ready to fire. So train yourself in such a way that you have this confidence to carry one in the chamber. But if you are not, if you are still not at that level, and for example, you still carry your handgun like this because you are not practicing enough, at least if you are making the same idea of training also with a knife, and I have the position of deploying the knife and coming here up, I repeat to you what, why I come with the knife up. Because in tactical combat system, we have not only the close combat fight with the knife, but we have also the possibility to transform the knife in a projectile weapon, to throw it if we have a secondary weapon, if it's an imminent attack and so on. So from here, it's very simple only to do this movement and to throw it. Then if I am here, I am using the knife to step from here, and then suddenly I have an attack and I must throw. So from here to here, it's dead time. And second, if you are there and I'm making this movement to you, already it's like taking a stone and wanted to throw in you, you would have some reflexes. So from here, it's much faster and much easy to throw my knife. So again, I'm coming here and I'm here, yeah? The same, if you are not carrying one in the one bullet in the chamber, but again, I advise you to train in such a way that you carry, I have the same movement. I am taking the close-up, I am taking the gun, and I am trying to come with it in the same position up, yeah, here, because this is a little bit from the Israeli tactics using of combat pistol, in which I'm coming with a hand up and I'm using discharging, yeah, it's rotating the elbow and then are going on the target. Only that some of the people are recommending to catch with the big finger and with the index finger, with the thumb finger and index finger from the slide, and making this move. In relaxation mode, it's going. But in reality, again, we come back to the same idea of fine motor skills. So I am using and I am advising when you are charging to catch with all, to grab with all the hand, the slide. It will be much faster and much secure to reload your weapon. So basically you deploy your weapon and you come in this position in which you can recharge, you can put bullet on the chamber and be ready to use. Okay, all this with movement, yeah? Understand that already you are a fixed target. If you are using another time to remain there and put bullet on the chamber, the probability that you will die, it's much more higher than you move, yeah? So if I am deploying, I am moving my body in such a way that I can not be anymore in that place, yeah? So I am winning a little bit of time. There are some schools like the Israeli school that they are not carrying one in the chamber. Everyone is teaching in different kind of styles. But I recommend to have one in the chamber, because this is taking you time and you are already having a reaction that is lower already from the action. But if you are not carrying, imagine also that, for example, I am in a close combat situation. I cannot create the space in this moment and I'm using the knife. I am coming here, deploying, taking the knife out, stab. The same idea, the same concept, it's also when you have the gun. If it's, I'm in a close combat situation, let's say I was making a cover, I am making a contra, and now I want to deploy my handgun, but I don't have bullet on the chamber, I am deploying it
and I'm coming in this position and I can use it like a hit, yeah? I am hitting with a metal slide in the face, mouth, eye, heart. Then I can create the distance, and when I create this distance, I can reload my gun and be able to use it. So basically, for the deployment of the knife, for the deployment of the gun, for the deployment of the knife with striking, for the deployment of the gun with striking, they are the same movements. I don't do other kind of movements because, remember, keep it simple and efficient. The same idea, this is the reason why in tactical combat system we have simple techniques and efficient techniques. If we are talking about hand-to-hand combat, I don't have, I don't know what complicated things, arm bars, join locks, or I don't know what kind of techniques. I have only some simple strikes that all the people are knowing to do it, yeah? They are simple and efficient strikes that they are there only to create, I repeat, the time and the space so I can deploy my fire weapon or my knife if I was in a very close, dangerous situation. So if I have a jab and a cross, the same thing I have with the knife. Only that I have now the knife in my hand. But it's the same technique, nothing more. I don't put my brain to learn I don't know what kind of movement. Then, if I have, for example, an uppercut, the same thing I have with the knife. Only that I have a knife now in my hand. Simple. If I have, for example, a hook, the same thing using the knife. I don't change nothing. Okay, I repeat, in tactical combat system are also things, simple techniques that can be transformed in complex techniques. But fundamentals are remaining these simple and efficient techniques. As already I was saying, you must find the right movements that you can use for all the elements. If I hit with a fist, with a punch, my fist is looking like this. If I'm using the knife, my fist is looking like this. If I'm throwing with the knife, there are so many techniques with the finger up like this. Very good techniques of throwing, but I'm not using it. Why? Because again, in a real situation, fine motor skills are not operating the same. So this, using my index finger to give the direction of the knife, it's a fine motor skill. So I was training to operate and to throw the knife in the same position, hammer grip, yeah, nothing more. If I am catching my gun, it is in the same position, yeah? It's basically a hammer grip, yeah? So keep it simple. Don't catch your knife, I don't know in what kind of positions, if they are complicated, the stuff. Okay, when you are advancing, when you are doing this from years and years, and you are mastering all these techniques, okay, you can begin to improve your techniques, to come with, I don't know, different kind of ideas and to try to raise the level of your techniques. But for the ones that want to learn the skill to be able in a real situation to protect their lives, their family and the ones around them, they need simple techniques that they can learn fast and they can be efficient in that moment. Another way that I can show you how simple you can change your way of carrying your tools, of making your techniques, it's by showing you a simple thing. The belt. All our life we have the pants and a belt. All our life when we open the belt, and you want to give a down from the pants, you are making this. The same movement that your brain already knows, I can do it by using the softy tourniquet. You go in a hostile environment and you want to conceal better your stuff. I was putting my tourniquet as a belt. It's coming very good. It's also keeping your pants and everything. If you want to, if you need it, it's the same. Only I'm making the clip from here and that's all. I am ready to deploy it. So a movement that already your body knows, you can do it so simply. The same when I'm using the flashlight, yeah? When I'm using the flashlight all the time, the flashlight is in the weak hand. Okay, this I'm talking about a situation in which I can operate with my weak hand, yeah, with the left hand. In reality, it can happen that you are wounded or you cannot use it. So of course, it's changing the tactics. But in normal condition, I will operate with the weak hand and my strong hand will operate the gun, for example, or the knife. So this is already here, yeah? So if I need, for example, I'm in a close distance and I'm using the flashlight to blind for a fraction of a second the aggressor, and I want also to hit. So my movement is from here, I'm using the flashlight, the part of the tactical flashlight, to hit, yeah? This is also for hitting. And this is applying in the same way by using my tactical pen. All the time my tactical pen is on the left pocket. On the right pocket, I have, for example, the folding knife, but all the time my tactical pen, it's in the left side. So when I need to operate it, I am catching it and I'm in the same position of hitting. This is the movement that I am doing with the tactical pen. I am not going there and do I don't know how many moves, because my tactical pen in my tactics, it's only for giving that strike to create the space and the distance so I can deploy my knife or my handgun. Yeah, if I was not able in this moment to do it. So I'm having this strike. It's the same idea as with the flashlight. Yeah. So very important, these things. Keep it simple, keep it efficient. Don't put your brain to learn I don't know how many moves. By adapting and combining moves for different kind of tools, it will be very easy to learn it fast and also to have that fast and efficient response in a real situation. Okay guys, this is the video for today. Don't forget please about the Project Tribe 13. You have a link in the description of the video. Check it out. Basically, it's a project that I'm working for a few months ago and I want to get together people that they want to learn knife combat skills, fire weapon skills, tactical medicine, survival techniques, to be better prepared in such a way that they can protect their lives, their family and the community in which they are living. So if you like the idea, if you want to support me and the Project Tribe 13, you can read more info on the link that is in the description of the video. And you can do also that by becoming a Patreon on the Patreon page of Tribe 13. Thank you very much, and until next time, take care.